counting down now on First Pitch in Washington, D.C. Major League Baseball on the Show starts now. We are just a couple of miles from the Capitol building at beautiful Nationals Park in Washington. A good matchup here for you tonight between the Pittsburgh Pirates and the East leading Washington Nationals. With that, we welcome you inside the broadcast booth. Matt Vaskirjian here with you. Alongside me are Major League veterans Steve Lyons and Eric Karros. And Steve, let's talk about the two starters that take the baseball here tonight.
Well, you see a guy here looking to get himself into double digits here in victories for this season. And I'd give him a better than even chance of doing it because he's been pitching so well.
Steve, EK will join us in a moment, but before he does, let's get a look at the starting lineup for the visiting Pittsburgh Pirates, as manager Clint Hurdle has his squad lined up like this. They'll match up against an imposing presence indeed. The number one overall pick in 2009, hard-throwing right-hander Steven Strasburg. Starling Marte will step in now. Late on the fastball there as this one skied out towards straightaway right. Therefore, it is worth one away. So Strasburg off to a good start in the first, and with that, let's take a look at how the Nats will align themselves defensively. It's brought to us by Majestic, the official uniform of Major League Baseball. Number 25 will stand in. Bases are empty, one man out. Here he comes on 2-1. And he's fallen behind now, 3-1. Hit hard. Foul. And a fastball blew it right by him, and they're two down.
And he was really late on this one. I mean, really late. You can see where the baseball is by the time he gets the barrel through. I mean, it's darn near in the catcher's glove already. That tells me he was probably looking for something else.
Russell Martin will have his first opportunity now as it comes with the bases empty here in the top of the first. Good break to that thing, and it's 1-2.
Well, he's a strike away now from going a strong 1-2-3 to start the ball game.
Here's the 1-2. Just does manage to get a piece there as this is bounced foul. And here's one that barely misses off the inside corner, 2-2. We're just getting started here in our nation's capital. Too high, ball three.
Yeah, and that's not the pitch you want to throw on 2-2. I mean, that was so high, he didn't even have to think about swinging at it.
And the payoff pitch is chopped foul at home plate, so we'll do it again. Still 3-2. On the eighth pitch of the at-bat is the one that finally does it as he wears him down and the inning is over. One, two, three, go the Pirates. Now it'll be Washington's turn in a scoreless ballgame. Starting lineup for Washington looks like this. Jeff Locke will get the ball to pitch against these guys, and he'll be given the task of really focusing on keeping these guys off the base paths. That means to be successful, he's got to focus on keeping the ball in the strike zone and avoiding the unnecessary walks. And a look now at how the Pirates line up on D behind him. Denard Span will stand in now, just a few ticks shy of the 300 mark for the season. There's a swing and a ball lifted to left, but back in the seats, out of play. It's 1-2. The 1-2. Hard hit towards center. But this is unfortunately right at him in center field as he takes it in for the first out. With that, let's give you a check of the scouting report, as there you see the arsenal on this 26-year-old left-hander. Anthony Rendon will stand in now, and as you can see, he enters play with 16 home runs on the season so far. A little bit outside, 2-1. And now pitch on the way. Here's one hit towards the hole, and that is through into right field for a one-out single.
Well, he needed a hit like this. Got to get him to snap out of this cold streak. I mean, you're just looking for something to go your way, and that ball, it's not hit particularly well, but it happens to find a hole. He's saying, man, it's about time.
Jason Wirth will get his first shot here with the runner at first now and one away.
Let's go, DC.
He's running towards second. Pitch outside. The throw is not in time as he just gets in ahead of the throw.
Just your classic single and a stolen base. Now with one out in the first, another base hit here could put that first run on the board.
Two-one pitch is a knuckle curve taken for called strike two. He took second fairly easily. Any thought of third base here?
I don't think so. Got a good hitter at the plate. A single is probably all he needs. I'd let him try to drive you in.
Decent lead at second. Here's the pitch. Swinging a ground ball to first. And he'll take this one to the bag for the out, but meanwhile the runner will move up 90 feet to third base.
Well, at the very least, he does move that runner up to third base. But with two away now, I don't think that's exactly what he was hoping to accomplish. I think he wanted to drive him in.
So a man at third here with two gone, and stepping in as the first baseman, Adam LaRoche. Now he turns on a fastball here and sends it deep down the right field line. And that will hook just inside the right field foul pole. It's a home run. Two-run home run for Adam LaRoche, number number 18 for him on the campaign. And the Nationals move out in front here, 2-0.
Well, this pitch is just a little bit in, not really a terrible location at all. But if you're sitting on that pitch in that spot, you can certainly do some damage. And he absolutely did some damage right there to the tune of a 2-run shot.
Ian Desmond will get his first opportunity now with two away, and the bases empty here in the home half of the first. Bases are empty here with two men out. Now the 1-2. Out in front of a changeup as he grounds this one to short. Throw on to Davis, takes care of him, and that'll end the inning. Nats pick up a pair in the inning on this 2-run home run. Second inning coming up. It's 2-0 Washington. Neil Walker leads things off now in the top half of the second. Here's the 2-1 pitch. Changeup called a strike, and he comes back even at 2-2.
Now at the plate, here's where you got to put yourself in the pitcher's head and figure out, what would I throw on a 2-2 pitch?
Swing and a miss, and he's got that strikeout pitch working now. That's 3 in a row for him as there's one away.
And for as hard as he throws, he's not just a thrower out there. I mean, this is pinpoint accuracy with his fastball. He puts it right on the knees on the inside corner. Not a whole lot you're going to do with that pitch.
Pedro Alvarez will get his first opportunity now. Fouled back. Now a ball hit hard towards center, and the Pirates have their first base hit.
Well, even when you keep him in the ballpark, he can be trouble. Here he's right on this pitch, and he smokes it into left field for a solid single.
Ike Davis will dig in, and this season certainly hasn't been all that kind to him as he enters play with the average down in the 230s. Davis waits on the 1-1. Now a ball swung on and heading for the stands in right, and that'll move the count to 1-2 now. And he gets under a fastball here as this is lifted the other way to left center. Harper is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first.
Batting seventh, left fielder, Travis Snyder.
Travis Snyder will get his first cuts here with two gone now and a runner at first. And he's right on the fastball there as this is hit pretty well out towards deep left. Harper is going to have room out there as he puts this away to retire the side. Pirates leave one. They're still down. It's 2-0. Bryce Harper will start things off in the bottom of the second. Now a ball lined to the right side. But therefore it is Davis. He spears it for the first out.
I'll tell you, if he didn't catch that ball, it would have knocked him down. This is a laser, but he manages to hang on to it.
So the bases are empty with one man gone. And that'll bring in the second baseman, Asdrubal Cabrera. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
That's enough.
Now the pitch. And he misses again, ball three. And this will be fouled away. And he lost him here on 3-2 as that pitch misses. It's ball four.
Batting eight, catcher Wilson.
Wilson Ramos will get his first opportunity here. And as you can see, he's got that average up over the 290 mark to begin play. There goes Cabrera. Swing and a miss, strike three. The throw, not in time as he steals second.
Yeah, this is going to be a 3-2 pitch. They send the runner here hoping to maybe stay out of a double play situation. The one thing you don't want is the strikeout, because normally they've got you dead to rights at second base. But he did get a decent jump that time, and he's going to wind up stealing it anyway.
Steven Strasburg will get a chance to swing away, and he'll have a chance to pad onto his lead if he can deliver something here with two away. Now a ball hit high in the air out to center field. Marte will get there, and he puts it away to retire the side. Some of our nation's young minds and future leaders here in attendance. Yikes. More in a moment on the show, the Friday Night Showcase. Jordy Mercer is ready to go here as we begin the third. Three and one now.
You can bet they'd love a ball four here. Now that would let this guy have a shot to bunt him over.
The 3-1. And he gets a piece of this one to foul it toward the backstop. Now a ball pulled hard but fouled off to the left. Swing and a miss as he ran the fastball right by him for the first down. Jeff Locke will be the batter. Three, one on the way. And he somehow gets that one by him. 3-2 now.
And I think he'll keep riding that pitch until these guys prove they can do something with it.
One out, nobody on. Now a swing as he rifles this one into center for a base hit.
Boy, how about that at bat from your pitcher? You started thinking this is already a really good at bat because he's seen so many pitches, but then he caps it off by finishing it with a base hit.
Starling Marte will get a second crack at it here. He flied out to lead off the ball game. And a possible double play ball here for Cabrera. Desmond for one. Relay to LaRoche is in time, and thanks to the double play ball, the inning is over. 4-6-3. They roll it up to get out of the jam. We're back to Friday Night Baseball on the show after this. Denard Span makes his way to the plate to get us started here in the bottom of inning number three. little too tall that time. 3-1 now.
And this is one guy you want to make earn his way on. Now, if you walk him, he can make it cost you with that speed of his.
And a changeup that time that's lifted in the air out toward left. Snyder is underneath this one, and he's got it for out number one.
And sometimes when you're just getting rolling here in a ball game, you've got a three ball count. Hey, go ahead and lay one in there. Make him prove to you that he can beat you. This winds up a pretty routine fly ball.
Anthony Rendon will stride in again. He singled and later scored his first time. Now a swing, and he just fouls this one away. Both teams with just two hits apiece thus far. Here comes the 1-2. And 2-2. And that misses there, so he runs the count full now. On deck is Jason Wirth. Now a swing and a ground ball. Throw on to Davis at first, and there's out number two.
The right fielder number 28, Jason.
So with two gone and the bases empty, that'll bring in Jason Wirth.
Go, Dad.
Here we go. And here's a fastball that he takes the other way onto fairly deep right. Number 25 is going to have room out there as he puts this away to retire the side. Three up, three down for Washington. They're up 2-0. Number 25 will dig in. 0-1 in the ballgame. Strasburg on 1-1. And here's a pitch swung on and missed. 1-2 now. And this is swung on and missed, though he will need to do a little housekeeping at first. And this is going to get right over the head of LaRoche. Trying to do a little too much out there, so that'll go into the books as an E2. Russell Martin will try it again, set down on strikes his first time. Oh, he breaks out the hook there. Good for strike two. You go back to the curveball here?
I'd stay away. I'd go curveball or even slider, but I got to get it out over the plate. My job as a pitcher, expand the zone. Make the hitter swing at pitches that are off the plate.
And now this ball's lifted in the air down the right field line, but this will get back into the seats, so the count holds at 2-2. Two-two one more time. And he's getting his money's worth up there now. It's full 3-2. Neil Walker waits on deck, making him sweat out there. The seventh pitch coming up. And this pitch is taken by Martin as it misses for ball four.
Just the first walk he's given up here so far to go along with just the two hits. So he's been pretty well in command throughout this entire start.
Neil Walker will stand in now with two on here and nobody out to begin the inning.
And on the mound, he hasn't found himself in too many rough spots so far, so this might be his first real test of the ballgame.
Whoa. The 2-2 coming. This one sinks low and a touch outside. It's a full count, 3-2. EK, where are you going now on 3-2?
I still got to work a corner. Not just going to throw it right down the middle and grab a strike. Can't be a giveaway pitch.
There's a drive into the gap in left center field, and this is going to split Harper and Span and make it all the way to the wall. And now third base coach Nick Leyva is going to wave him on home. And he will score as well, and this game is knotted up now at two apiece.
Yeah, he squared that one up pretty good. No chance to run this one down as you see it one hop the wall out there, and he'll ease his way into second with a two-run double.
Pedro Alvarez will dig in. He singled his first time around.
It runs on.
Pitch, a curveball that's off the catcher's glove and gets away. And over to third now is the runner.
That's a tough chance there behind the plate. This is a curveball. You see him try to smother it, but this ball just eats him alive, and that's going to let that runner move over to third now on what'll be a wild pitch.
Let's get you out here.
And this is on the inside edge, perhaps off the inside edge, but it's a called strike, 2-2 now.
Oh, he's got a legitimate gripe right there. I don't know about that one.
Two runs, three hits, and no errors so far for the Pirates. And he reaches out to get this one as it's grounded to third. Throw to first is in time, but meanwhile, the runner is in to score.
And here's just a case of a guy at the plate doing the little things to help his team win. And he gives his guys the lead here following the RBI groundout.
Ike Davis will dig in here. He flew out his first time around.
Come on, Nat, let's go.
And he lays off it to even the count, 2-2. Struck him out as his fine season continues on the mound. Now 200 punch outs on the campaign.
If that long top of the third took anything out of him, he's not showing it right now. As he's really bounced back strongly here in the fourth.
Travis Snyder will try it again. He flew out his first time. Fastball misses in the dirt as he tried to get him to chase the low one.
And you kind of get the sense that his head isn't in it right now. You got to put all your concentration into that hitter. You can leave worrying about the pass for your film session tomorrow.
Now a check swing as he's able to fight this one off. Foul. And this is hit well towards the hole. And that'll get on through into right field for a base hit. And now time is called here as their pitching coach is going to pay a quick visit to the mound to discuss how they want to attack things here. Jordy Mercer will stride in again. He struck out swinging his first time. He's ready now. The pitch to two balls and two strikes now.
Yeah, that's a great pitch on 1-2. You start it in the zone, and hopefully you'll get that guy thinking he needs to protect. It turned out to be a good take.
Swing and a broken bat as this ball's hit on the ground. Throw on to LaRoche is going to be in time, and the inning is over. So they pick up three runs on only two hits in the inning. two errors in the inning and a runner left on. To the bottom of inning number four we go. Pirates lead it 3-2. Adam LaRoche will lead things off here in the home half of the fourth. And a good spot for that pitch is it's chopped foul. And he'll fight just to stay alive here as this is fouled away. And this is going to be a foul ball. Here he comes again, 1-2. Line to the right side, but that's a foul ball. And they take him out of the zone here, and he obliges. Not the greatest of swings there for the first out.
And when you know you've got a guy in protect mode up there, and he's fouling off pitches left and right, that's when you know you can just keep taking him further and further away. He winds up getting the punch out here on a pitch that's well out of the zone.
Ian Desmond will stand in. He grounded out his first time. Here's the 1-1 pitch. Oh, he pulls the string on the circle change, 1-2.
Boy, he might be pressing his luck a little now. That's two straight pitches right down the middle.
Swing and a ball hit hard on the ground towards second. Fielded cleanly by Walker. Throw on to Davis at first, and there's out number two. So with two gone here in the fourth, let's check out our pitch speed comparison for the two starters. And whoa, look at that for a top speed. 98 miles an hour. That man is flat dealing. Bryce Harper will stand in now with two away, trying to avoid another 1-2-3 inning.
Now, this has been total domination these past few innings. They haven't been able to mount any kind of threat whatsoever.
And this is fouled back and out of play. It into right field. Really squared that one up perfectly. It's a base hit.
Well, that was one heck of a battle there at the plate. You know, the more pitches you see in an at-bat, the more likely you're going to get something good. Delivers a sharp single there.
As Drubal Cabrera will dig in, drew a walk his first time around. Now a fastball that just misses here as the count moves to 2-1. And he gets a piece of it here, but it's chopped foul. Fastball strike three called on the outside corner, and he can't believe it. I don't blame him, but the inning is over. One left for Washington. They're down 3-2. Jeff Locke will come in now to lead things off against our starter, who probably wishes he had a mulligan to use on that last inning.
Yeah, he was doing just fine up until the last time he took the mound. He's got to hope that that was just an aberration, or he might not stick around to see another inning.
And some action out in that Washington bullpen now as we see both a left-hander and a right-hander throwing. Swing and a ball lined hard towards short. And the fifth inning will start with a ground out, one away.
And that ball is rifled at him that time, and it just about took him into left field. Somehow he gets his glove down there and makes a nice play.
Starling Marte will dig in. He's flown out and hit into a double play in two trips. Runs up to bunt here, but this is going to kick just foul down the line. To two balls and two strikes now. Now here's the pitch. And he goes the other way with a fastball as this is hit in the air toward the gap in right center. And this is handled easily, so quickly two are gone here to start the fifth.
And here's a guy that needed a quick inning after giving up three runs the last time around. He's got the first two outs here. He's looking a lot more determined out there now.
Number 25 will stand in now. A punch-out victim twice already. EK, I'll ask you because you're the one sitting next to me. Do you approach an at-bat differently when you have two strikeouts under your belt this early in the game?
Well, you do in the sense that whatever you did the first two times, it wasn't working. But I think if you start worrying too much about trying to avoid the hat trick or worse, it'll start becoming a mind game and you'll start falling into some pretty bad habits.
And they'll go off speed here as this pitch misses. It's 2-1.
A much better approach here at the plate so far. Now he's not working from behind in the count like he has his first few at-bats.
2-1. I had him guessing that time as he's barely able to foul it away. Up the middle, and it's going to get into center field. It's a two-out hit.
Yeah, he got a little revenge there. He struck out twice before that, and now he gets him back with a solid base hit.
So we're runner at first here with two gone in the inning, and that'll bring in the all-star catcher Russell Martin. Some activity out in the bullpen now as a couple of left-handers begin to stir. And this pitch is taken by Martin as the count moves to 2-1 now. Could have been 3-1. Instead, it's 2-2.
Yeah, looked like you guessed right on 2-1. That was a good time to swing for the fences.
Throw over to first, and the runner back safely. Two-two pitch is lofted in the air out to right field. And Worth will put this one away with ease to retire the side. One left for Pittsburgh. They're up 3-2. Back with Eric Karros and Steve Lyons, Matt Vasgersian here as it's Wilson Ramos that gets set to lead off the Nationals' half of the inning.
Come on, Matt!
Here's Alvarez at third. Throw across by Alvarez is in time for the first out.
The pitcher, number 37, Steven.
And there's a fellow who had some late game heroics as a pinch hitter in 07. Scott Hairston grabs a shillelagh and he moves on deck. ready on 2-1. And this is going to be a foul ball. And a tough pitch on two strikes as he's able to foul it off. And he just gets a piece there as this is chopped foul. Swing and a hard liner to short, but the shortstop won't have far to go to haul this one in, and there are two away.
Well, this is just kind of a little soft humpback liner, and these look like the easiest plays in the world, but Eric will tell you, sometimes a ball can knuckle on you a little bit. It didn't happen to him right there, and that's an easy play.
Denard Span will dig in now. He's lined out and flied out in two trips. Here's the 2-1 pitch. Swung on and missed, and it's even at 2-2.
Well, this pitching staff has done a pretty darn good job against him in this series.
Has to fight to stay alive as this is fouled off to the right. Two runs, three hits, and two errors on the Washington line score. Swinging a ball hit on the ground, and Davis will just watch this go by. It's a fair ball. Anthony Rendon will dig in here. 1-for-2. He's singled and grounded out so far. Now the 1-1. And he gets some pretty good wood on it here as this is lifted to fairly deep left. Snyder will get there, and he puts it away to retire the side. Nationals leave one. They trail 3-2. Jerry Blevins will get the call here as he'll start the sixth inning on the mound. Neil Walker will be the first one to greet him, as he'll have to turn around and bat from the right side of the plate here. Pitch on the way. Just did get a piece of that one, so he stays alive here. And this ball is also hit foul and heading for the seats, so we'll have to do it again, still 2-2. Swing and a liner toward the gap in left center, and this is going to find the alley as he might have himself his second double of the ball game. And he will coast into second with a leadoff double.
Oh, that one sounded great off the bat. That's a good, crisp line drive right here to start the inning, and he'll make it up to second with a leadoff double.
Pedro Alvarez will step in, 1-for-2 in the ballgame. Just does manage to fight this one off as it's fouled away. And a little battle brewing here as he fights off the two strike pitch and chops it foul. And he misses there for ball four. So runners are at first and second now with nobody out.
Now batting, first baseman, Ike Davis.
Ike Davis will stand in now. He flew out in his first time around and then was a strikeout victim last time. Runners staying tight to the bag at second. Here's the pitch. And he lays off there, ball four. So back-to-back walks have him in business here with nobody out.
And he's saying, give me a break. I mean, that pitch is right there. And I tell you, though, complaining like that is only going to squeeze that strike zone a little more.
So a big spot here. Bases loaded, nobody out. And that'll bring in the left-handed hitting Travis Snyder. And that misses. Ball four. A run will come in to score.
And the bases loaded walk there just adds to a disastrous start to the inning so far. Four have batted, four have reached, and with still nobody out, this has the potential to get even worse.
Jordy Mercer will dig in for the third time now. He's struck out and bounced out in his first two trips. And a curveball's by him that time as he falls behind now, 1-2.
Now you got to beware of that sinker. I mean, he'd take a strikeout right now, but I think he still just wants this guy to hit the ball on the ground.
And a swing and a miss on a huge first out there as he sets him down swinging with the bases loaded.
And that changeup's not really a pitch you can sit on with two strikes, because if he gives you that fastball, you'll be an hour late on it. That's a great job of not showing that pitch until he was ready to punch him out.
Jeff Locke will stand in now with the bases loaded, and this is one at-bat he doesn't want to just throw away. He can really help himself here.
Yeah, hitting is not really in a lot of pitchers' DNA, but you're right. If he can find a way to just find a hole with the ground ball, that could be huge.
The 1-1 home. Swing and a miss on the sinker, and it's 1-2.
This would be a big time to pick up back-to-back strikeouts if you can get it.
Bases are loaded with only one out. And that misses 2-2.
Oh, that's a tough take, but a good one. The pressure's still squarely on the pitcher out there. He's still got to come in.
To right field. Catch made by Wirth, and now here's the runner breaking from third. The throw is offline and nearly over the catcher's head as they extend the lead to three.
Oh, that was taking a big risk. You've got to know you're trying to score against a guy that's got one of the best arms in the business, and he sets up and makes a great throw here to the plate, but that runner's just able to slide by safely.
Starling Marte will step in now and see what he can do with two on and two out here in the sixth. Good job of holding up on the low ball there, and it's 1-2.
And now here, 1-2, this is where you need your best pitch. You've got to strand that runner out there at second base and keep the deficit just at three.
Not much of a lead at second. Now here's the pitch. And this is fouled back and out of play. Now a ground ball towards the hole. Throw on to first, and they're able to escape the monster inning as the side is retired. So two runs on just one base hit, no errors, and two men left on base. Heart of the order, 3, 4, and 5 coming up. It's the Pirates 5 and the Jason Wirth will step in now to lead off the inning as his guys look to maybe break the rut they've been stuck in.
Yeah, and after that first inning, it's been all zeros since. And once he kind of got settled into that groove, he's been a difficult nut to crack.
in for strike two.
Yeah, a little surprising he didn't offer it that one. That was a dangerous spot for a good fastball hitter.
And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2.
And now with that pitch count getting up there just a little bit, you can see that some of these pitches are missing just a little farther away than they were earlier.
2-2 pitch on the way. And this one will be out of play off to the left. Maybe an excuse me swing there as this is tapped in front of the mound. Throw on to first in time, one away.
And we get a look there at his pitches by inning. He's at 81 now after that last pitch, so he should be good for a little while longer.
Adam LaRoche will stand in here, but before he does, let's take you back to the very first inning. This was a two-run home run right out of the gate that really got these guys off to a fast start. Misses there, ball four.
Now remember, this guy homered off him earlier in the ball game, so he may be a little gun shy this time around. Understandable.
Ian Desmond will stride forward now. He's bounced out a couple of times already here in the ball game. The 1-2 with one away. Now a half swing, but it's strike three anyway, says the home plate umpire, and that's out number two.
And here this is one more time on show track. You can see he checked his swing there, and I think he did so in time, but you can clearly see that that pitch is in the strike zone, and I think ultimately that was a called third strike.
Bryce Harper will dig in now, 1-for-2 to this point. Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. Throw on to Davis takes care of him, and that'll end the inning. One left for Washington. They trail 5-2. Back here at Nationals Park, it's on to the seventh inning with the Pirates leading in this one, but before the inning gets underway, let's check out the game summary to this point. Craig Stammen is on to pitch now as he'll take over to start inning number seven. Number 25. We'll lead it off here in the top of inning number seven. Three, two, here it comes. And a good take there as they'll have a leadoff man aboard to start the seventh. It's ball four.
You can't fault the pitch selection or the location there. It's well placed, maybe just a hair off the outside corner. But 3-2, that's where you want to be.
Russell Martin will stand in here. 0-for-2 with a run scored so far.
Keep that runner close.
Oh, I think he thought it was ball four, but the knuckle curves in there.
Might not be a bad time to have a look over to first. Make sure they don't have any ideas of trying to send him to keep out of the double play.
And he makes good contact there, but this is going to find the stands foul down the right field line. Now the fastball is right by him as he swings and misses for the first out of the inning.
Oh, that's a sweet pitch right there. You know, on the mound, there's very few things that can happen negatively with this location. I mean, you're either going to swing and miss, you foul it off, or you hit it into the ground where it becomes a double play. But I'm sure on the mound, you'll take the strikeout.
Neil Walker will step in. He doubled and later scored his last time. And there he goes towards second. Not in time. He's in there at second.
Boy, I think he's pretty lucky to get in there safely on this play. It's a decent jump, but I think a good throw might nail him down there. Instead, you see it's wide of the mark, off to the shortstop side of the base, and he's able to beat that tag to get in safely.
Here's Walker, well hit, deep left field. And that'll get down for what should be extra bases. And now third base coach Nick Leyva is going to wave him on home. And that'll score the runner from second to make this a 6-2 ball game now.
Well, that's what he's done well all season. And that's swing the bat with runners in scoring position. He drives in another one here on the RBI double.
Pedro Alvarez will stand in. He's 1-for-2 so far. Runner at second here with one man out. And this is down at the knees, but called a strike. Wow, it's 3-2 now. Third double of the game for these guys, as you see the comparison there. Now a swing by Alvarez as he launches this one high and deep to right field. Over for a look is Worth, but this ball is gone. A home run. A two-run blast to straightaway right field. Home run number 16 for him on the year, as it's now a 6-run ball game.
And you know, the only way you're going to tie this guy up on the inner half is if you go up and in. If you leave it belt height, he can handle that pitch, and he handled that one all right.
Ike Davis will stand in 0-for-2 in the ball game so far. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
And now, as a reliever, you've got to go out and give 100% and focus on the task at hand. And you can't let the emotion enter the equation, or it'll mess up your concentration and things will get even worse.
And just lucky to make contact on that one as it's chopped foul. Sets the 2-2 pitch. Now a swing as he shoots this one over to first. And LaRoche will just take this to the bag himself for the out.
The left fielder, number 23.
Travis Snyder will stand in. Base on balls his last time.
Come on, DC.
That's inside and low. It's a ball and two strikes. And this ball will be chopped foul. And a swing here from Snyder and a ground ball out to second. Throw on to LaRoche takes care of him, and with that, the side is retired.
ladies and gentlemen.
But they strike for three in the inning, two on this two-run home run. Get up and stretch, home half of the seventh coming up. It's the Pirates 8 and the Nationals 2. As Drubal Cabrera will step in now to lead off the home half of the seventh. And some action now in the Pirates bullpen. They've got a lefty and a right-hander up to throw. Full count, 3-2.
Yeah, and on 2-2 to start an inning, that's a call you'd like to get.
Out of play. Here's the 3-2 pitch. Boy, really making him work now as the seventh pitch of the at-bat is also fouled away, so the count will hold steady at 3 balls and 2 strikes. And he's just going to make him throw as many pitches as he can as he fouls another one away, and it's still folded 3-2. Pitch swung on and hit in the air toward the line and right. Number 25 is there, and he has it for the out.
Well, that was a struggle with a capital S, but he finally gets him to lift the fly ball here to end the 9-pitch at-bat. That'll take some life out of the arm.
Wilson Ramos will step in now, 0-2 to this point. Here it comes, 2-1. And that pitch comes over to catch the corner. It's 2-2 now. Well, that pitch isn't going to light up the radar gun, but it's been effective.
Well, it doesn't have to. If you get that good movement and put it in the right spot, it's plenty good enough to do the job.
Off-speed pitch, and there is strike three called. And boy, that zone just got a bit larger, two away.
Well, I think he's upset here because that pitch has not been a strike all night. You'll see here on show track, it's still not a strike. He's got a definite gripe. I'd want to have a word or two myself.
And we're going to see a pinch hitter in this spot as the right-handed batting Kevin Franzen begins to loosen up on deck. Two out, nobody on. And that swung on and fouled straight back. Another try at 2-2. And that one never threatened the zone. It's gone full now to 3-2.
Such a good at-bat right here. When you can grind out 7-8 pitches against a guy that's running short on gas, that can be huge.
Boy, really making him work now as the seventh pitch of the at-bat is also fouled away, so the count will hold steady at 3 balls and 2 strikes. Driven down the left field line, will it stay fair? It will as it heads to the corner, a fair ball. He'll get it into second, and the gamble will work out. He's in at second base with a two-out double.
And this is a welcome sight for these guys. It's just the second extra base hit they've had tonight. And it comes at a time when they really need to start stringing some base hits together.
Denard Span will get an opportunity here in a run scoring spot now following the two out double.
Let's go, Nat.
And he takes ball four. So now at least they're set up for the force at any base here with two away.
And there you get a look at his pitch count. You can see he's over the 100 pitch mark right now. So some of those mistakes are going to start to get magnified late in this ball game. You can bet they're keeping close tabs on him in that dugout.
Anthony Rendon will get his shot now with two on and two out here in inning number seven. Two men are on with two men out. Now a swing and a high fly ball, and this one has some carry on it to deep right field. And the two-out threat will not come to pass as the inning is over. Nats leave a pair, still 8-2. Drew Storen will come on now in a mop-up role as he'll just try and keep this deficit from growing any larger. Jordy Mercer will get us going now in the top half of the eighth. Looked like ball four there, but instead it's 3-2 now.
That thing's coming in there hot, 96 miles an hour.
Strikes again, so get your hats out. That's the third strikeout of the game. Moving closer towards our conclusion now. 8-2 the count in this one, as our line score will give you a look at how we got to this point in the contest. Josh Harrison will get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher.
Number five.
Bases are empty, one man out. And this ball skied in the air out to Span in center. And that's out number two.
Good start to the inning here out of the bullpen. After three runs came in to score last inning, they needed someone to come in here and slow that offense down a bit.
Starling Marte will stride in, grounded out his last time through. And some action out in that Washington bullpen now as we see both a left-hander and a right-hander throwing. 3-2, here it is. Now a fastball as he just reared up and let that one fly, and the inning is over. Down in order go the Pirates, but no matter, they lead it 8-2. Tony Watson will come in now working with a huge lead, so he'll just look to get some work in here. Jason Wirth will stand in now, and he's been kept quiet out of the number three hole, hitless in his three at-bats so far. Swung on and hit softly on a line. Whoa, but that's just self-defense as he spears it for the out.
You know, this guy's been a savior out of the bullpen for this team so far this season. His ERA is under two coming into play, and he gets the first man to greet him right here.
Adam LaRoche will try it again. He homered back in the first inning of this one. Two and one now to LaRoche. And he misses low here, so the count goes to 3-1.
And this is where a guy who's been around a long time knows, hey, we're not going to make up the difference with just one swing. It's going to take base runners. So that's a good job of being really patient at the plate.
That's in there, and it'll run the count to full, 3-2.
I think if you gave him another chance, he'd be swinging at that one. That was a great pitch to hit.
The pitch. And he just manages to stay alive here as he fights this one foul. One out, nobody on. Ooh. Boy, really making him work now as the seventh pitch of the at-bat is also fouled away, so the count will hold steady at 3 balls and 2 strikes. And he finally wins the battle as this is swung on and missed for the second out. Ian Desmond will stand in now with two away, needing to really get something started here.
And their chances of getting back into this ball game are growing dimmer by the batter.
Come on.
Ball hit pretty well out toward left center. Marte is going to have room out there as he puts this away to retire the side. Nationals gone in order, still 8-2. Number 25 will get us started as they look for a little insurance here in the top of the ninth. Here comes a 1-2. Good hard sinker, but he lays off to even things at 2-2. Fouled back. Ball three. 3-2 now.
Let's go, Nat.
Now here's the pitch. And this pitch misses here. It's ball four, and they've got a leadoff base runner aboard to start the ninth.
The catcher, number 55, Russell Martin.
Russell Martin will try again. Struck out swinging his last time through.
Let's go, Nat.
And this pitch is taken by Martin as the count moves to 2-1 now.
That's a pitch you really have to learn to take against a guy like this. But even if you make contact, you're just going to get something in on the label. So that's a great take.
Now the 2-1 pitch. And he goes the other way with a fastball as this is hit in the air toward the gap in right center. And this is handled out there by Spann for the first out.
Now batting, second baseman, Neil Walker.
Neil Walker. We'll see if he can keep it going. 3-for-4 thus far. Runner at first here, one man out. Sinker is right there for a called strike two. And a sinker sinks too much there as it bounces into the catcher's glove.
Yeah, an interesting setup now on 2-2. Here's where you really need to pay attention to that guy at first.
Two-two pitch is a fastball high, so it runs full, 3-2.
Now the question, do you send the guy on 3-2 with one out? You figure you're going to get something around the plate.
And this is going to be a foul ball. Swinging a ball line down in the left field corner, but this will be foul. holds off on the slider, and that's a good idea as it's ball four.
Third baseman number 24, Pedro
Alvarez, will stand in again, and we'll take you back to the seventh inning. This was a two-run home run, and it was one of the key blows in the ball game thus far. Just a bit low. Tough call, but it's 2-2.
And now on 2-2, I don't think he'll be nibbling any longer. He's got to come in with something here because he for sure does not want to run this count full.
And this pitch is foul tip right into the glove of Ramos as he stays with it to record the strikeout.
Yeah, and there are some times where you characterize a pitch as a sweeping slider. This one does not fall into that category. I mean, this is a nasty little break at the end. Tough to do anything with that.
Ike Davis will try again. 0 for 3 thus far. A swing and a miss there. 2-2.
Wow, what a good time to take something off of that pitch. And they had him fooled pretty good on that one.
High in the air and deep down the left field line. And he gets there as he had a lot of ground to cover that time, and the side is retired. A couple of walks, but no damage. More in a moment on the show, the Friday Night Showcase. Bryce Harper will step in, a ground out victim his last time. Here's the payoff pitch. Reaches down and hits this one on the ground to short. And the throw to first is in time, one gone.
Good job out there on the mound. Down in the count 3-0 to start this inning, he comes back to retire the guy on a ground ball.
Asdrubal Cabrera will stand in. He flew out his last time up. Now here's a swing and another chance out there at shortstop. On to first, and Cabrera's a ground out victim. Two away.
Two more ground outs, and that's the product of throwing that sinker. Just about every time you swing at it, you're either going to hit the top of it or miss it altogether. And if you do hit it, you're going to be killing all the worms out there in front of home plate.
Wilson Ramos will dig in. Took a cold third strike his last time. And this is fought off at the plate as it's chopped foul. Bases are empty here with two men out. Here's the lefty's offering on 1-2. 2-2 now with two away and the bases empty. Here's a swing and a ground ball, but this is going to be a foul ball as that keeps things at 2-2. Now a swing and he pops him up, and this should do it. Davis is there to make the catch, and with that, the ball game is over.
And you know what? I don't care who you're playing. You know, it's never easy to go out on the road and win any game. So that was a great effort by them in every phase of the game.
The offensive star of the night for the Bucks, well, it was this guy right here, Neil Walker. Can't ask for much more. He's our Topps player of the game.
Yeah, he was a thorn in their side all game long. You'll see there, he winds up with a three-hit ball game, and a couple of those were key hits that helped lead his guys to victory.
So that's a wrap here tonight. For my partners in the booth, Eric Karros and Steve Lyons, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. And for more, click on over to theshownation.com. The Pirates win it 8-2. Good night from D.C.